We're coming back from a short break, and remember, this is the economy turn pointer, where we've been discussing on the traffic jams and their effects on the Kenyan economy. Dexary, the police have been accused of causing, of being the major cause of traffic jams, especially during security checks, roadblocks, and even after accidents, taking a lot of time, which causes jams. What's your take on this?
I think, to me, roadblocks are there for good reasons. But when it comes to implementation, the implementation itself may not really be the way it's supposed to be. Roadblocks are supposed to be there to weed out bad people, drivers. Maybe if Al-Shababs are hiding themselves in there, and so on and so forth. And it has to be smooth, so that whatever they want, they need to do it as fast as possible because people are on the road. But you find that some of them are very slow when they are implementing this, when they are on the roadblocks. They take their time. They may stop vehicles coming from left and then stop vehicles coming from right. And many of them target passenger vehicles. And I don't know why, maybe they know why, but they may target matatus, they stop them, while when they stop them, the private vehicles are behind, are being inconvenienced. So roadblocks are good, but the problem is the implementation aspect. And then to add on it, there are these way bridges, of which are notorious for bringing to a standstill traffic. Check the one for Mariakani when you are entering Mombasa or coming out of Mombasa. You may find that the lorries may be around 3 or 4 kilometers long, and yet the road is very small. And the guys who are actually checking those vehicles are there minting money from these people. Oh, you have an overweight load here. And then one day they were flushed out because they delay, because they are after money, they are after negotiating how much money they should be given and so on. Such things must be removed. In fact, from the way I'm seeing, we may lose a lot of business, Kenyans, to Tanzania, going inland, because of these roadblocks. Lorries take very long time. Instead of taking maybe 2 to 3 days there in Uganda, they may take 2 weeks because of these roadblocks. And our police are notorious for having to ask for this money every time and then. So I think we need to rethink about roadblocks, whether or not they are serving the purpose they are supposed to serve. Thank you.
Thank you. I think what Daktaria said is substantially good, in the sense that if you find really the roadblocks, if they serve the intended purposes, it will be good. If they don't, then it will not be good. And I want to move to the others. There is a time in Kenya when we say roadblocks should be removed, and they were removed by a certain commissioner. And what was the effect? Was there an effect? Because that is one of the, if we remove the roadblocks, are we serving the purpose? You will find that there was nothing which we lost and nothing which we gained. From maybe the security men can tell us more, but when we look at from this end, say that you find that there was free flow of gas from one side to another side, and if it can be implemented that way, you'll find that we'll serve to save some time for the people who are transporting, people who are moving from one place to another one. So long as the roadblocks which we have, because if we use the roadblocks for our own purposes or for the negative reasons of which we should not be, for example, what you say, Daktaria say that it can be used, you don't check anything, you only check what your interest, you only stop the car to check, for example, the matatus and all that, then leave the others, and maybe the others are actually carrying the most criminal things. So to me, if you look at the vehicles, the congestion of the cars, it might not really be caused by the roadblocks, but roadblocks can slightly contribute towards actually the congestion. But if we can remove the roadblocks, we'll serve, it will not. I've seen that. We have seen that in Kenya. It cannot really serve us. So it's better we remove, to me.
Gentlemen, as we finalize, what can the government, both the national and the county government, do in order to sort out these disturbing issues regarding the jams, traffic issues in Kenya?
Thank you. Immaculate, many things can be done, both by the local government, that is the counties, and the central government. Starting with the counties, they can bring in some policies which will ensure that there are roads or there are no much of congestions within their counties. For example, if you can have, I have not seen, but if it can serve the purpose, for example, the street lights, not the street lights, the what do you call it, the, where we have the lights come, the cars move, the green, yeah, those lights which you can control the vehicles in the roundabouts. The other thing which Daktari said is true, you can even remove the roundabouts and do other things which can be able to assist so that we can really be able to come out of the old age roundabouts. No, there are other things we can do now as opposed to having the roundabouts. The third one is actually to ensure that whatever the culprits, but the people who are breaking the law are really taken in so that they are actually, they pay for it. And they should be instant justice, not to be meandered around. If you have made an error or a mistake, you need to be told to pay there and there a fine, and you are given a receipt so that you have you flow movement. If you are going to Bungoma and you have made a traffic jam or a cause something, you may be like the over whatever that is where you use a long rein and all that, you need to be charged and pay on the spot so that you can move. Otherwise, if you don't have anything to pay, then you can be able to be taken in or that. So that really, you are not delayed for not having caused the error. You need to be, you'll be fined. And so many things. Central government can really regenerate some other issues like policies, which can be sent to counties to ensure that all these actually, apart from collecting the revenue, actually we remove the congestions in the roads. Thank you.
Yeah, I think I agree with my colleague. So number one, the rule of law must be enforced. That one there is no thing about. How can they do it? The fines are there. But fines are not enough. In other countries, they fine you, yes, but then they add some value to your, they deduct some points to your insurance. When you are going to insure your car next time, your premium will be up. Instead of paying 20,000, you'll pay 30,000. Or 40,000. So that is a pinch. Otherwise somebody says, I can just pay 5,000 and that is it. No. Remember, at the end of when you are going to insure again your vehicle, you will pay more dearly. That is will help us to kind of deter this. And then lastly, again, I still emphasize roundabouts must go so that we just have flyovers. We don't stop to wait for the vehicle to go. Then the third one, the southern bypass and the eastern, the way they are doing in various towns, they must put malls there and other things that will actually make people use that road. If not, then that will be a very big problem. The last one is corruption. We need to weed up corruption. And we have to make sure that people get their licenses in the right way, not because they have given money for them to drive. I think that is very, very important. Thank you.
Thank you very much for keeping it the Economy Trendpointer. I've been your host, Immaculate Burunji. Until next time, God bless you.